Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of me flipping through Starlog Magazine. We're on Starlog number 49. And look who's on the front. Oh, it's my favorite James Bond, Roger Moore. Bond is back for your eyes only. Don't worry, I won't sing. Don't worry. We have Escape from New York, exclusive interviews with Kurt Russell. We have George, Mr. Sulu himself, Takei. We have George, Star Wars himself, Lucas. Oh my gosh, whole bunch on here. And we're going to talk about Raiders of Lost Ark, because guess what came out? What a great year for me. Raiders of Lost Ark came out, so I became an Indiana Jones fan. Instantly, because who doesn't love that movie? And James Bond, my favorite James Bond, put out a new movie. What a great year for me as a youngster. Alright, this issue came out August 1981. You can see here, you can pause it if you want. You want to look at the features and departments. Oh yeah, you remember this movie, everybody? I do. Love it. Wolfen. Oh, what a great movie. You know what's funny? I read the book afterwards, you know, years later. And, oh, the book's really, really good. Really, really good. Yeah. Yeah, Whitley Strieber wrote the book. He's the one who wrote that Communion book about aliens. Very good writer. Back in the day when you wrote into a magazine, good times. I think people need to slow down a little bit. Maybe just write a letter once in a while. I don't know. Clash of the Titans. Love Clash of the Titans. Wow, that was on a lot growing up. Clash of the Titans. Something Wicked This Way Comes. Well, that didn't come out till, when did that come out? Like 87? This is 81, so yeah, I guess it's been in the works that long. Wow. Yeah, when did that come out? I don't know. I have to look that up. What do we have here? The Deadly Spawn. How cool is that? We have the Muppets down here. Alright, let's turn the page here. This is very interesting. Oh no. You're incredible. The most incredible book of all time. By H.P. Lovecraft. So it's compiled. It's a Sorcerer's Handbook compiled 880 by... Oh, it's... That's right. H.P. I remember that. I'm an H.P. Lovecraft fan, so he talked about this. So someone compiled all this to make it a real book. I never knew that existed. That's pretty cool. We got Mork and Mindy down here. Wedding Bells. What? Oh, James Bond. We got Cannonball Run. Come on, this is all fun stuff. Yeah, Roger Moore. He was in that. He played himself. He played Roger Moore. Here we go. Kurt Russell. And am I even lined up? I'm not even looking. Okay. Kurt Russell and Adrienne Barbeau. I met her at a convention. She was really nice. I don't have any pictures. I do, but I don't know where they're at, so I can't show you where I would. But yeah, she was really nice. Really nice lady. Anyway, Escape from New York. What a fun movie that was, man. Gosh. Am I lined up? Yeah, decently enough, so we can see everything. Storyboarding and special effects. Raiders of the Lost Ark. Yep. How cool is that? This is a Raider storyboard. That is pretty neat, folks. I love it. I knew it was stuck together. I felt it. Yeah. There's the plane. Yep. Derek Medley, Meddings, the man who creates the magic for James Bond. Wow. How cool is that? There's Roger Moore. Look, like it didn't go down very far. Remember the scene? The scene, it falls down, oh my gosh. Forever. But in real life, it was, look, you can see it was on. That's a great, I love For Your Eyes Only. Great music. Music normally is John Barry, but John Barry couldn't do it. Is that my phone? I think it might be. John Barry couldn't do it. So he asked his friend to do it, Bill Conti. Bill Conti did the music for Rocky and Karate Kid and, oh gosh, a million things, but my brain's broken, so I can't remember. But Bill Conti's music is just so different than John Barry's. I love it. A lot of people did not like it, but I loved it. That ski chase scene in this movie, and for you guys on that music, oh my gosh. I probably listen to it at least once a year, that soundtrack. It's just fun. It's a fun, fun soundtrack. Yeah, speaking of soundtracks, there you go. Hopefully I paused long enough for you to pause. How's my microphone? Making sure it was on. I've done that before. I've done a whole... I can't remember which one. Oh, it was an Indiana Jones comic. I was doing Indiana Jones comics. I did the whole thing, and my microphone wasn't on. So I had to do it all over again. It was like, aw. Look at that. Goldfinger. Thunderball. Wait, is this... Oh, that's Goldfinger, too. Both these are Goldfinger. So we're talking about Goldfinger, or just talk about the special effects? The film base... Yeah. Special effects. I love it. I love James Bond too. I think I talk about it. There's certain things I just love more than anything. It'll be James Bond's one. Ooh, I want to get these magazines. I might have to look for those. The local magazine shop. I don't know. Anyway, I love James Bond, Indiana Jones, Star Trek, Godzilla. There's more. All everything Halloween. Just, yeah. So every horror film ever made. I love scary movies are my favorite. That's my, is that what the kids call it? My jam, is up the kids say these days. But there's certain things I've loved since I was, gosh, since I was born practically, and I still love today. Star Wars, that's in there. There's so, yeah. These are so cool. You can see why I have these magazines and I can't get rid of them. You probably, well, this is part two. So maybe I don't have issue 40. What issue is this? Sorry to do this real quick. 49? Yeah. Well, look for issue 48 if you want a part one. That's my fault. I don't go in order, so. George Takei, part two. Mr. Sulu discusses fandom, rapid transit, politics, equal time, and of course, Star Trek. I dwelled on a little long as I was reading. But very interesting. Might have to read that too. I say that a lot. Mind Warp. Pyramid Power in Outer Space. I don't remember this movie. Is that weird? For a guy like me who's watched pretty much every movie known to man. So who's in this? Robert Englund's in it. Wow. Aaron Moran. Edward Albert. Ray Walston. I have to seen this movie. I just don't remember it for some reason. I had to have seen it. I probably own it. That's what's funny about me. That's a classic Jamie move too. I probably seen it and own it, but right now don't remember. Look at all those magazines. I have a few. I don't have this one. I'm a huge... that's all I've been trying to... I was going through my collection for these videos. For you. And I'm like, I'm missing some good ones that I really want. Like, I'm a huge James Bond fan. I've already said it like 50 times. But I would like to collect, you know, all Roger... Anytime Roger Moore's on the front cover. You know. Raiders of the movie serials. In their new film, Raiders of the Lost Ark, George Lucas and Steven Spielberg pay homage to the great action-adventure serials of the 1930s and the 1940s. In more ways than one. I said this in my last video, I think, didn't I? I don't know. How it's not hard to make these movies again. You don't even need to put a lot of money into them. People are like, a movie's going to cost $300 million. I'm like, well, that's why they made Spy Smasher back in the day. In the Mass Marvel. In the Batman serials. Because they were cheap. You can still make these cheap, guys. and make tons of money because people will kill to watch them. We want real stunt people. I mean, why do you think the John Wick movies are successful? You know, well, they're kind of expensive now. I think you're on John Wick 47. And, you know, but anyway, when he first started out, they were just really good stuntmen doing really cool stunts. I mean, there was hardly any story. Think about the story real quick on John Wick 1. Exactly. That's all we want. Us action fans, we just want some really cool stunts. We want people jumping off cliffs. You know, like, why do you think back in 1977, Spy Loved Me, everybody loved that movie? It's because a guy really jumped off a cliff. We didn't know there was a parachute until the last second. All of a sudden, a parachute opens up, and we in the audience are going, what the heck? Because we knew it was real. But now, you know, if you don't want a cartoon jumping off a cliff into a cartoon sky, landing on a cartoon ground, that's not, you know, that's not real. Anyway, I went on a tangent. Sorry about that. I love movies. I just wish they'd come back. I think it has to. I believe in pendulum. Pendulum. Everything in the world is a pendulum. Sometimes it'll go way too left, way too right in the crazy world. But there's that one in the middle is what we want. And I think it's going to swing back in the movie world where it goes back in the middle. I mean, it happened. Think about it. The big studios. Oh, I'll give you a good story. Well, it might not be a good story, but it's a story. Big studios were making those big Bible epics. You know, like Cleopatra and the Moses movies, you know what I'm talking about. Big spectacles, tons of money invested in them, and they weren't making money. The studios started worrying, and they started selling off stuff because they had to try to make, you know, make money. All of a sudden, out of nowhere, all these independent movies, like Easy Rider would be a good example, shot on a $0 budget, made tons of money. I think that's what's going to happen again, folks. I think it's going to come back. The pendulum's going to swing back. Independent movies are going to start. I mean, look at the Oscars recently. If you look at it, none of those are big budget movies. They're like $20, $25 million movies, which are cheap, you know, for nowadays. I mean, the newest Indiana Jones movie cost $300 million. I don't see where that money went to. The CGI it does not look good. It looks like a cartoon. I don't know. That's my tangent. But anyway, you see what I'm saying. I think it's going to swing back. People are going to start making real movies again, shooting in the real world. And CGI is fine. You know, maybe you have to take away, like you shoot a scene and somebody walks into the scene, ruins it, or there's a car in the way. You can CGI that out. You see what I'm saying? I get why CGI, or maybe you need to make the building a little bigger. That's fine. It's not taking away. You're shooting outside, you know? So, you see what I'm saying. I'll get off my soapbox. Me talking about movies. I don't even know what the last couple pages were because I was just talking. I know I started on George Lucas and I went crazy. But yeah, I think we're fine. You can pause. Yeah, I just love movies so much and I just end up watching old movies all the time because none of the new ones really... I haven't seen a new one I liked yet. I keep watching. Don't get wrong. It's not like I'm not one of those people who say, I refuse to see this. No, I'll be the judge of that. I'll watch it. I'll watch a movie. But usually I watch it and I'm like, eh. Or I forgot about it instantly. I'm like, eh. I've watched a lot of Tubi, which is a free channel that has a lot of old movies. So I'm just catching up on some old movies I missed when I was younger. So that's what I've been doing. Anyway, hope you like this. Me talking forever, nonstop. But hope you like the issue, though. I love James Bond. Hope you like James Bond, too. I hope you enjoyed that, even though I talked forever. But everybody have a great day. I'll have a great day, and I'll see you next time, okay? All right, everybody. Bye-bye.